Dionysus Park was owned by Sophia Lamb, Chief. Sort of a private retreat for her social experiments. One night it flooded, killing all her guests. Paper said it was cult-related. Come on up to the train station. Let's rendezvous.
Dionysus Park. His death is our rebirth. The life of the people's daughter is in your hands.
Yours truly is the newest member of the Rapture family. I fed Wales a line about how the Tribune was stopping me from telling the people what's what, and without a word, he hands me an invite to this artist's retreat here at the park. Lamb bought my frustrated novelist act. She's even sponsoring me to ink it while I'm here. Except, my story's all about her. And I don't think she's gonna like the way it ends.
Dear Yellow Eye Girl, my name is Billy, and I saw you the other day at the merry-go-round. I think you are very pretty, and I like your blue dress and the songs you sing about angels. My mom says your dad is scary, but I think he is strong and nice, like a comic book hero. I got you a gift and put it in the basement where nobody will find it. The secret code for the door is 1080. I hope you like it. I will wave to you next time I see you, so you know it's me.
I'm told that Lam has been seen in the streets. One of the Alpha series was killed in the incident, and his bonded sister stolen. But the Council has no time for a manhunt. Atlas swells the ranks of his marauders by the day. Regardless, Lam's name has already faded among the people. She is no more than a ghost who has forgotten to die.
Yes. If you enjoy slime and muck, it's utterly divine.
Oh. Bloody fucking die. Listen, princess, next time you eat out of the trash, I want you to think of me.
A lady's got to have some sense. This is still my home. Out!
God damn it! Gotta change it up! Watch me! What? No! I've been hit harder.
Bienvenido al amorito!
Just let me!
She knows precisely how I feel about this celebration of unconscious art. The artist reflects the world as it ought to be, not as it is damned to be by some spasm of the lower mind. I shall not censor. The park is Lam's property. However, if the case we are building against her proves true, I will return with a sledgehammer.
Well, the good news is I've located a new train car, but the station's still locked down, and we're not alone in here. I see a shadow in the security booth. I'll lay low while you have a gander.
Well, hello, boys. The name's Stan Poole, Rapture Tribune. Quality paper. Before the locals stopped reading and started finding, other uses for it. Anyway, I'm looking to cut a deal, fellas. Come by the train station. I'm here in the booth.
I found her. Found Cindy by this rusted carousel. But she was just standing there, staring, waiting for the music. And she doesn't even recognize me. What have they done to her? Listen to her.
The man in the moon is a girl, Mr. Bubbles.
Listen, if anyone hears this, I have to know how to cure her. I... No! Get back! She's my little girl!
McDonough, listen. There's a hell of a structural flaw here in Dionysus Park. A leak in the primary drainage pipeline could flood this whole joint. Faulty pressure locks would seal in every sorry soul. One clumsy big daddy knocks open the wrong pipe and, hey presto, Lamb's little art show turns into Fish City. God forbid the wrong element finds out.
Your face, baby! Partners! We were partners! Share like I said. But I heard your mind. You were thinking about taking it all for yourself. Why would you throw away our friendship?
Hiding.
Don't just try to please. Say something!
Dionysus Park was my home, Delta. An experiment in social unity, cut short by human folly. You dishonor its memory with every step.
Now that, see, Lamb knows you're here, but I'm incognito. Thing is, since you drained out the park, the little sisters are already starting to nose around, looking for Adam, and, I can't have that.
Hey, Sasha! Crack the safe already! I want my goddamn toy surprise!
Oof, so terribly close. Why won't you cooperate?
Skinny shot, Sasha!
Thank you.
Fowler? My mother's pearls? You bastard! For coming.
Take this, Father, and hurry. Mother can't hear this, but she's... she's looking right at me. And her face...
Okay, so dead men tell no tales, right? Wrong. See, with Adam involved, every stiff's got a story, and Lamb knows how to read it. If that stuff makes it back to her, I'm an obituary. So, I want you to take the story of Dionysus Park and bury it. Get rid of the little sisters for me. Your way. Do that, and I'll unlock the station here. Scout's honor.
Well, I'd say he's hiding something, but he sort of took the fun out of that one. He's locked in the security booth, however, so we'll have to play along. Find those sisters.
I hear a...
You heartless...
she is. Little Tyke wants to be in pictures. Real cute. Now get rid of the muscle and deal with her. See? You put it to work, and all that atom ends up in you. But you're sort of a silent partner. So that's tops with me.
Describe her as a kind of secular saint. But dividing her loyalty evenly across the world at large spreads it so thin as to be invisible to some. Love, I have found, is beneath her. Naturally, Ryan arrested her, gave her to Sinclair to incarcerate somewhere. But upon her escape, she took the city and changed my life forever.
Oh,
You mistake my nature, Delta. I wish no Adam for myself. Eleanor is the dream, and she needs neither weapons nor parlor tricks.
Thank you.
bad at all. Wait. Earthy. Oh, I can't kid myself. This lifestyle is a disgrace. How could you?
Bodies here. Normally, only a little sister can see them, but I can show you what Stanley's trying to hide. When Mother was taken away, Stanley was left in charge of Dionysus Park. He spent all her money through these mad parties. It was like he was trying to ruin her.
You okay there? Keep your eye on the brass ring, brother. Find the rest of the sisters.
It's me.
Subject Delta's just a serial number, amigo. I did a lot of digging on you for a feature once. They used to call you Johnny Topside. Found the city all on your own in a diving bell. Real shame what they did to you.
Thank you.
Goddamn face. Who'd have thought? Rapture. Paradise of the confident man. I gotta keep revising the Atlas voice. I figure the accent gives me an excuse to lock myself in a room with a bottle and count the cash. War's on in full now, boy. And I've got a hell of a surprise for Andrew Ryan. Long time coming. And right about now, I expect the prodigal son is booking his flight.
There she is. Get her. I hope that bodyguard ain't one of your long losts.
I'll get you.
are we gonna...
So, Ryan's goons are sweating me to prove this place is a closet commune. But I need time. Lamb's kid keeps staring me down like she knows that I'm a phony. I keep thinking of Johnny Topside, though. It took real guts to find Rapture like he did. It makes it easier not to crack if I sort of imagine that I'm him. It's a good thing I can't tell Lamb that, though. She'd probably say I got a secret need to fall into his arms and make a wild whoopee or something.
Bienvenido al amo, amigo!
Came back! What are you-
Here's the angel!
Yeah, I'm...
Mom, Daddy? Here.
Me there. I confronted Stanley, said I'd tell Mother what he had done. He panicked, took me away and sold me to an orphanage. I tried to fight back. I remember biting his hand, but Father, he's the reason I was turned into a little sister.
Now, you were just a deep-sea explorer with iron cojones, pal. The public gave it a nickname. But Ryan was sure you were a spook. So his people locked you up. Erased your damn name. Goodbye, Johnny Topside. Hello, Subject Delta.
Adam is Rapture Delta. The finest minds of paradise in a single sublime mosaic. Eleanor, consider the genius you deny her with every stolen drop.
When all this is over and we're divvying up Rapture's bounty, you and I'll be holding court on a private island, son. Think of it, each world power on bended knee, holding a bouquet made of money.
The girls you've saved from Mother want to thank you. Check the Gatherer's Garden.
be hot or cold.
All of you!
I'll bring my sword.
You must learn to play poker, Eleanor. Like anyone, I am flawed and have a fierce genetic bias towards competition. But each Saturday, I read the other players, and I pick a man who will benefit the most from victory. By the final hand, I ensure that he takes home my entire stake and that of the others. I win with the feeling of conquest over myself and the wealth of my competitors. Is slowly reshuffled according to their need.
Really?
Awareness of self is no miracle, Eleanor. It is a trick of the gene, an endless inner refrain asking, what's in it for me? To serve the world, we must grow deaf to the self. Are you ready? Now, stop listening to my voice. Stop listening. Stop. Difficult, isn't it? Human verbal cues are defensive coloration, camouflage. Play this recording until you no longer hear the words. Then you may observe the people for who they are.
command the security system. Charge to summon a friendly bot anytime. A nastier swarm snicker as they seek out one enemy after another.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Maybe I'm crazy.